man in the middle, ARP poisoning, hijacking connections. How does all of that actually work? Now, especially if we're studying ethical hacking or learning about cybersecurity, these are going to be terms that we absolutely hear. I'm going to show you how to do ARP poisoning with a man in the middle attack, but we're going to capture it with Wireshark so that you can learn how the protocols actually work. Instead of just pushing buttons on a tool, we're going to learn how these protocols actually do what they do. So let's get to it. All right, so ARP poisoning with a man in the middle attack. To do that, we're gonna use a tool called Ettercap. Now, if you've never used Ettercap before, go ahead and go download it. You can install it on your machine, or if you have Kali Linux, it's already right there for you. Now, here I have my two VMs, and on the right here, I have my Kali Linux box. And on the left, you can see I've just got a Windows 10 machine. So what I'm gonna do, the Windows 10 machine is gonna be my target machine. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna intercept traffic coming and going to this machine, and I'm going to be able to do so by staging an ARP poisoning attack, a man in the middle, from the Kali Linux machine. Now, both of these are guest VMs on my local system. However, if these were machines on a real connected cabled network, we could also do a very similar attack. Okay, so to start off, to look at how this is going to work first, let's take a look at my Kali Linux machine. I'm gonna do something called ARP-A. And what I'd like you guys to do is take a close look at the MAC addresses that we see here. So here in my system, it can see three other machines. It can see .3, .15, and .1. Well, .1 is our default gateway. So all I want you to do is just pay close attention to those last four values that we see here, 3500. Okay, just try to burn that in the back of your mind. Also with .15, you can see there 27CD. That's the virtual MAC address for the Windows system over here. Okay, so just to be sure though, let's go ahead and do an ifconfig. So by doing an ifconfig here, I can see what my local address is on this machine, on the Kali Linux machine. So 2.4. All right, so now that we have a bit of a lay of the land here on the Kali machine, let's go ahead and go over to the Windows box. So I'm gonna go ahead and just open up a command prompt. And what I'm gonna do is come here, I'm just gonna do ipconfig. Okay, so here I can see that this is the machine that's 2.15. And if I do an ARP-A, here I can see the systems that this machine knows about at layer 2. These are the other MAC addresses that it's aware of. So let's go ahead and take a look at that first one, 2.1. There we've got 3500, sounds familiar. It was the same one that the Kali Linux machine knew about. And if I come to .4, there I can see 5372. Okay, so this is just a simple network, only a couple machines and a default gateway. So now, how does a man in the middle ARP poisoning attack really work? Well, let's go ahead and take a look. So here I've got my Windows 10 machine. Okay, so Windows 10, and he is aware of the router, right? He's already ARP'd for that router. This is .1, and that router's responded, so he's aware of what his MAC address is. In order for Windows 10 to communicate out into the internet and off this network, it's very important that he know the MAC address of that interface. So we saw that in the ARP table. Now, when he sends a message out and a message comes back in, this gateway needs to be aware of the MAC address for the Windows 10 machine. So that's already happened. They've already ARP'd, they're aware of each other's MAC addresses, so now those MAC addresses can be used as the source and destination MAC addresses in the Ethernet frame. And we're gonna see that in a little bit in Wireshark. So here's the issue. If I'm on a switch, if I'm just on a network switch here, so if I wanna come in here like a hacker, or hopefully an ethical hacker, and I wanna intercept that traffic, this is where I do my man in the middle from. But here's the thing about a network switch. You see, when the Windows 10 box sends a message over to the gateway, the switch is only going to forward it out to this outbound interface. The switch already knows where that gateway is because it's already heard its MAC address and updated its CAM table. Well, the same is true in the opposite direction. When the gateway responds, when it sends a message or a message comes from another network back to this Windows 10 box, that gateway then sends it over and the switch will only send it out that outbound interface. So if I'm sitting here like an attacker, if I want to be that man in the middle, if I'm sitting here, I don't hear anything. I'm only gonna hear broadcasts, multicasts, and traffic to and from myself. So I can't just plug into the switch and just hope that I can capture the traffic to and from this Windows 10 box. So in order to do so, really to break the rules of switching, if you will, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to tell the Windows 10 box that I am in fact the gateway, and I'm gonna do that with ARP. I'm gonna go ahead and tell the Windows 10 box that I'm .1. And over here on the other side, I'm also gonna send an ARP packet over here to the router, and I'm gonna say, hey, I'm actually .15. So now both of these devices think that I'm the other one. The Windows 10 box thinks that I'm the router. The router thinks that I'm the Windows 10 box. Okay, so let's actually do this man in the middle attack now. Let's actually see how we can use the Ettercap tool to do that ARP poisoning. So on Kali Linux, before we bring up Ettercap, first, I also wanna make sure that you have a setting in your system, and it's an important one. You see this system control net.ipv4.ip_forward=1. This is a command that we have to enter into our system in order for our system to actually forward traffic on. Otherwise, if the Windows 10 box thinks that I'm the gateway, I'm not gonna forward that traffic on to the real gateway. This is what allows that forwarding to happen. So this is an important thing we have to do before we kick off Ettercap. Okay, so now that that's set, I'm gonna go ahead and close this. I'm gonna come up to my drop-down menu and I'm gonna type in Ettercap. And I'm gonna go ahead and use the graphical Ettercap for now. And while I'm doing this with Ettercap, something else I'm gonna do in the background is do that thing that we all came here to see, and that's the Wireshark stuff. So let's go ahead and open up Wireshark as well. Okay, so what I'm gonna do in the background before I actually start to inject those ARPs is I'm first gonna capture them, because I wanna make sure that you understand at the packet level how Ettercap is doing that ARP poison. So I'm gonna come up here to Ethernet 0. That's gonna be the interface that I capture with. I'm just gonna double click it, and now I have Wireshark running in the background. All right, so let's go ahead and just put this off to the side. All right, so now with Ettercap, I go ahead and bring up Ettercap, and my primary interface, Ethernet 0, that's the one I'm gonna select. And for right now, I'm not gonna do bridged sniffing. I only have one interface coming into this VM. I don't have two interfaces, packets coming in one and going out the other. It's all coming in and going out of the same interface, so I don't have to use bridged sniffing here. All right, so let's go ahead and check this. All right, so the first thing that I have to do with Ettercap is I need to tell it who the two targets are, the Windows 10 box and also the gateway, so that it knows how to build that ARP poison. Now, to make this simple, I'm first just gonna come up and hit the search key button, that search thing. And what that does is it actually sends out a bunch of ARP traffic, scanning through the local subnet and then looking at what systems respond. So here I've got four hosts that were added to the host list. Now here's something to think about. If you're trying to be really stealth, and if you're doing an actual pen test, that's something that you're not gonna wanna do. You're not gonna just throw out the fact that you're ARPing the entire subnet. That could trigger some alarms. So just be very careful if you use that search. Here in my little lab, I don't care about that. However, if I was on a pen test, that's something that I'd wanna think about. Okay, so let's go ahead and come up now to my hosts. Here I can see what systems I have active. Now, this is where I can configure my man in the middle. First, I'm going to take a look at 2.15. Remember, that was the Windows box that we have over here. That was 2.15, and I'm gonna come and make him target number 1. After that, I'm gonna come up here to 2.1, and I'm gonna come over here to target number 2. All right, so now I have my two targets configured. So now let's go ahead and set up that ARP poison. Before I do that, I'm gonna come back out here to my Wireshark capture. I'm just gonna reset this just to make sure that I can see, I don't have to see all of those ARPs. Go ahead and continue without saving. Come back to Ettercap. Now let's go ahead and come up here, and this gives us our man in the middle menu. Just for this video, we're just gonna look at ARP poisoning. So let's come here, go to ARP poisoning, and this is gonna ask a couple questions. So it's gonna say, okay, sniff remote connections, only poison one way. We can just leave this at the default sniff remote connections and hit okay. So you see here over here in Wireshark, we're actually able to capture these ARP poison attacks. So what we wanna do, let's go ahead and see if it worked. I'm gonna come back over here to my Windows box. Now remember, before I thought that 2.1 was at 3500. That was the MAC address of my gateway. But let's just take a look now. Let's go to ARP-A. And now let's take a look. You see now 2.1 has changed. Now 5372, or the Ettercap box. Windows thinks that that's the gateway. All right, so how did that happen? Well, if I come here, here I can see, let's go ahead and take a look at this first packet here. Let's actually take a look at the packets. That's gonna be fun. Okay, now I'm just gonna come down here. I'm gonna select that first ARP that I see. This is the first packet that went out when I actually did the attack. Okay, so Ethernet 2, let's go ahead and take a look at these MAC addresses. So the source is coming from the man in the middle box, and I'm sending it to 27CD, which is the Windows 10 device. All right, so that's the unicast from the man in the middle box to Windows 10. This is an ARP. Let's go ahead and expand this and see what this looks like. Now, here's the key. If I take those, if I take a look at this down here, this is an opcode reply or a to. So this is what we call an unsolicited ARP reply. I'm giving the Windows 10 box an ARP response that it never asked for. It didn't ARP for the gateway. I'm just telling it, this is the gateway's address. All right, so let's just see how that works. Here's my sender's MAC address. This is 53.72, so that's the man in the middle. And I'm telling him, hey, I'm 2.1, right? So I know that your gateway is 2.1. That's who I am. I'm impersonating him. Now I'm the target. This is Windows 10 device and Windows 10. Well, right after that, check out what I do in the opposite direction. Now, if I come down to the next packet down, this is where I can see I'm coming from the man in the middle and I'm going to 3500. So this is to the gateway. But check out what I'm saying to him. This is a reply. So again, this is not an opcode one. That would be an ARP request. Instead, this is just a reply. Who's sending it? Man in the middle. This time I'm acting like I'm 2.15. So now I'm the Windows 10 device. I'm acting as if I was him. So the man in the middle, that's how it does the ARP poison, is it sends these unsolicited ARP replies in each direction to the gateway and to the Windows 10 device. What that does is that breaks their ARP table thinking that I'm actually the gateway and the opposite in the other direction. So let's go ahead and see if that worked. So I'm going to come down here. Remember before we weren't able to capture those ping packets, right? So I'm going to scroll all the way to the down and I'm going to take a look at ping www.google.com. And over here, now I can actually see those ping replies coming. I'm capturing and forwarding those pings through the man in the middle. Now let's see what else we can do. If I just open up Microsoft Edge over here, let's open up a browser and let's do a little browsing. You can see over here on the right, bunch of traffic going by. I'm capturing packets, a lot of black lines and red letters. We're gonna talk about that stuff on my channel, don't worry. And if I come up here, let's just go ahead and hit our favorite site, wireshark.org. Now here I am capturing traffic passively. This is how I'm able to execute a man-in-the-middle poison attack. I'm making Windows 10 think that I'm the gateway, and I'm making the gateway think that I'm the Windows 10 box. So here my page loaded, I was able to capture that traffic, and just for now, what I'm gonna do is run back to Ettercap, and I'm gonna go ahead and stop my man-in-the-middle attack. Now, just because we were able to do that right now with ARPs doesn't mean that we're able to decrypt everything that we just saw. Everything that went by us, especially those TLS sessions that we saw, those are still encrypted. But for the purposes of this video, what I wanted to do was show you how an ARP poison actually works. Remember that you're sending unsolicited ARP replies in each direction, and that makes each endpoint think that you're the other party. So if you like this video on a man-in-the-middle attack and how an ARP poison actually works at the packet level, let me know. Go ahead and comment down below. Please like, subscribe if you haven't, and we'll make sure to do more content like this in the very near future. Take care, packet people.